How's doing, guys? Is Huck here? I've decided to take my sling off a week early. It's not that I'm going to keep it off, but I'm getting a bit of motion in my arm, and I want to try and exercise it, even if it's only for a little while. Now that the Israeli-Palestine ceasefire is, or sorry, let me get that right. Now that the Israeli-Hamas ceasefire is in place, I thought it would be interesting to make the video. I really didn't feel I could make during it. Whereas I do have an opinion on whether Israel should be allowed to defend itself or not, while people are dying, I don't think it's really right to get in the middle of the fray. I don't think it's the thing to do. It's actually one of the annoying things is people having opinions on stuff that have real life fucking life or death consequences. Whereas we all have them, we really do. But even to the point where I didn't really make a video on Scottish independence coming up to the referendum, because even though I am Scottish, the effects of the referendum would not really apply to me because I don't live there anymore. But I do think that Israel has the right to fucking blow Hamas up. I'm not saying that they've got the right to blow Palestinians up. I'm saying that if one, if Scotland, right, for whatever reason, right, we won't go into the. See, this is the thing. It's a bit like the fucking Northern Ireland issue. How far back do you want to go, right? During Ramadan, there was some protests in East Jerusalem. Rocks were thrown, tear gas and rubber bullets were fired. Hamas said, if you don't stop the trouble in East Jerusalem, we're going to start attacking, and they fired something like 600 rockets into Israel. I believe 200 of which landed in the Gaza Strip because they were ship biscuits, right? Israel has the right to try and dismantle that if they want, right? I mean, I don't get it. It's the old fucking American thing of we can protest, set fire to stuff, and attack people. But if you retaliate, oh my God, look at them—they're retaliating, right? It's a oh dearie me, look at the Proud Boys—they're fighting back thing, right? Two things I want to point out. First of all, how much money do you think it cost to build the 10 or so underground tunnels and the 2,000 rockets that were fired into Israel, right? If the money spent on them were instead spent on hospitals, education, infrastructure, right? Above ground infrastructure that isn't for the purpose of beating people up or attacking or kidnapping Israelis. Surely that would have a better effect on the international community than giving the Israelis the out of look at all these fucking missiles and tunnels they've got. It's a proxy war, isn't it? It's an Iranian versus Israeli war, right? And it's just been fought in Palestine, right, by Hamas. And let's be honest here, right? In 2007, when Israel says, right, let's split West Bank and Gaza into separate entities, into Palestine, let them have free and fair elections, right? I think, was it Fatah Party won in West Bank and Hamas won in Gaza? And the first thing that Hamas did was throw the Fatah party members off the roof and killed them, which is incidentally the same thing that Iranians do with homosexuals. It would be nice for some consistency as far as the protest is concerned. The people that are does that how can people who support gay rights also support Hamas? I don't get it. In the Iran by process of yeah. The other thing I wanted to point out is in the UK there was cars of people with Palestinian flags saying they wanted to fucking wipe out the Jews. And in America there was attacks on Jewish people that isn't being, I mean, no, I was going to point out, does it, I don't want to segue too much out the thing, right? But there was a news story about a guy in America who got knelt on and laughed at as he was dying, right, by the police. And the reason there's no riot in the streets is because of the white dude, right? Because it's Jews that have been attacked, there's nobody protecting them, right? There's nobody siding with them, really. To the point where I never felt that I could make a video about it because, especially here in Ireland, I think you would get some, because the Palestinians are supported by the IRA, are supported by people that are sympathetic to the Republican movement, right? Because they see similarities between colonization of Britain into Ireland and colonization of Israel into Palestine, when it was actually a UN decision after the fucking Second World War, wasn't it? Okay, so you've got these people, Palestinians, attacking Jews in America or in Germany or in Britain, right? Or you've got, sorry, you've got Muslims in these countries. So you've got people from one country who have immigrated to a second country, driving down the street with flags of a third country, telling people from a fourth country to get the fuck out of the third country. It just doesn't make any sense, right? And nobody's protecting them. I don't think, doesn't it? Do you know what I mean? It's a big up to Austria for putting the Israeli flag in our government buildings, right? And look, I'm no saying I'm siding de facto everything that Israel did, right? But if you fire 600, 2000 rockets, right, that just possessing 2000 rockets when you're a terrorist organization that wants to wipe another country off the face of the earth, right, shows that any previous peace agreement was not actually true. Right. Building tunnels into Israel so you can attack, right? And then you remember Hamas fired first. It totally null and voids any perception of peace, any perception of wanting peace, right? Hamas has and always will want Israel wiped off the face of the earth. And when you're dealing with that, and remember, you've also got Hezbollah, you've got Iran, do you know what I mean? Yeah. Rant over, I'm pretty sure. I try not to tag these types of videos because I don't want abuse for my opinion. But that's what I think. Let me know what you think. Am I right? Am I wrong? Till next time, guys. This is Huck. Peace out.